for patience to challenge Crank in a Protoss versus Protoss. Symbol is already gone.
Symbol is already gone, and now Crank has to play a Protoss versus Protoss since the player for Team AZUBU is going to be patience, and it's a pretty good choice. Crank is struggling, or has been struggling in the past against Protoss players from Korea. Against international Protoss players, he has been doing a little bit better, but he has a 0% win ratio against Korean Protoss so far.
Yeah, and patience wants to keep it that way. He's chosen Polar Knight as the map. Not a map that really sticks out to me as a snipe map for Protoss versus Protoss, but it may be that AZUBU does not want to use this map later on, or rather, don't want to face this map later on with some of the players they may see coming up in a little bit.
And with Patience, the AZUBU coach is also taking a little bit of a risk. Patience has been winning in his last match against C in the opening game, but then he lost the second game right away. He's one of the younger players and one of the ones that doesn't really have a lot of experience and exposure, especially here in the offline environment of the GSTL. But he's been showing some promise, and if he can take down Crank, that would be great, but he's unexperienced. So the AZUBU coach is taking a bit of a risk here, which is one of the things that he's known for.
Definitely true, but sometimes those risks certainly pay off. Crank, definitely somebody who's not going to get nervous either. I think that Patience definitely just needs to keep his wits about him here, because he is facing the player now who has destroyed the best player that AZUBU has to offer, and so he's got to keep himself focused here, play a Protoss versus Protoss on Polar Knight and win it, because if he doesn't, then his team is going to be 0-2 with two good players already knocked off.
Exactly, an innovation not even playing just yet. He's of course the best player on the team these days and the one player that everyone is watching out for, so every team is just looking for a sniper against innovation, that one's for sure, but so far he doesn't even have to come out. It's game number two here at the GSTL, AZUBU up against Axiom-Acer, and Patience has to deal with Crank. Let's see if he can achieve victory for his team here, going into the game at the GSTL. Starting to the top of Polar Knight, we have the Protoss player for Team AZUBU.
AZUBU, patience.
Gerard had a lot of patience, almost too much, in using this guy.
Yeah. That is definitely true. But well, the opponent at the bottom right already defeated Symbol today. Can he edge out a second victory? It is
Axiom Prank.
Can he crank out a second win?
A couple of foreign fans I currently have. Greetings.
Yeah, thanks for coming.
Coming all the way from New Zealand, from Auckland. These days we're having a lot of Kiwis in the studio. Last week we already had a couple of visitors from Auckland. And the trend continues.
Yeah. I've never been to New Zealand or Australia, but I do want to go.
You should. It's amazing.
It's in my checklist of things to do before I die. And if I go and I really like it, it's going to be in my list of things to do twice before I die. If I like it then, then it's going to, you know.
Should
the things to do multiple times before I die.
Should make a bucket list. I actually crossed a lot of the things that I wanted to do already off. Not all, though.
You're the bungee jumping type. I see. That's not me.
Yeah, bungee jumping, skydiving, all the things that I really wanted to do while I was still studying in university, I already did. So still have a couple of things that I wanted to do.
So that's all my things I hope somebody doesn't force me to do list.
I always kind of wanted to do an Ironman, but the problem is that my knee is sometimes giving me a little bit of trouble if I do too much running. So I'm not sure. Like, I think I might give it a go at some point, but that's one of the things that I'm always like a bit on the fence. But doing an Ironman would actually be fun. Or at least like a triathlon.
Yeah. Do those probes see each other, I wonder? If they're both paying attention at the exact moment, I'm still not even sure if the watchtowers reach each other, but I don't think they saw each other. But regardless, scouts are coming through here. And a quick tech to Stargate for both players at the exact same time before Warp Gate research. And both players are also going to scout this. Unless that probe died to the result, that would have been really silly. But they both see. And so both of them are going to have to go Phoenixes instead of Oracles. If either player goes Oracle, they're taking a huge risk.
Yeah, that would be the suicide Oracle right there. But even if they go into Phoenixes, it's going to be a really funny game. If you go Phoenix versus Phoenix, things sometimes get completely out of control. We've seen a lot of games like this. Actually, wasn't it the Patience against C2 played exactly that style and went into the range upgrade first?
Yeah.
Wasn't that the game that we casted on hand there?
Yes.
Yeah, that was exactly what he did back then. But now we have actually Crank going straight into a Twilight Council after his Stargate.
I'm going to check and see if he canceled that. No, he didn't cancel the Stargate. So he's just... he's making the switch right away. And he may actually go into DTs. Because here's a thought process that may be going through his head right now is, okay, you're not going Oracles because you see that I'm going Stargate. And if you go Oracles and I go Phoenixes, your Oracle dies. So you're not going to have Oracles. Probably not going to make Robotics either. So I'm going to go DTs, and you're going to have Phoenixes, which aren't useful. You're going to try to get an Oracle out. So that could be his mind process here. And that's exactly it. There's the Dark Shrine.
Yeah.
So I really like that idea.
Dark Shrine is coming in now. He also can, of course, then later on use Holy Blink to take down a couple of those Phoenixes, but the problem really is he needs some anti-air. If he gets those DTs into the main base of his opponent, that would be amazing, but he needs something back at home that can deal with it. And he's trying to just keep a couple of Phoenixes close and then, if need be, get a Photon Overcharge to make sure that Patience is not doing too much damage.
It's a pretty big gamble, too, because the Dark Shrine is likely to be scouted. In Phoenix versus Phoenix play, somebody is always going to be harassing you with Phoenixes. So far, he hasn't seen it. He did not commit to going to the main base. And Crank really has his fingers crossed that doesn't get scouted. If it does, then he still has a window of time where he can do damage. It's almost complete. He has a very forward pylon all the way at the natural of his opponent. So he's going to have those DTs in the main base really quick.
And the DTs, of course, could be countered by an Oracle that comes in and then grants vision. But the big problem really is that that will cost him a lot of time. And that's time that he just doesn't have.
Yeah, and he just scouted. There's no Oracle whatsoever. If he actually warps in like three DTs and goes straight for the Stargate, he can kill the Stargate before the Oracle is ready and win the game.
He also goes into an expansion play. And once that we see the DTs coming into action, oh my god, he did actually miss the pylon here with his Phoenixes. Once the DTs come in, another problem that he's going to have is that he cannot really attack this expansion of his opponent. So that's a lot of time that he's going to lose there. And he doesn't even build an Oracle just yet. He has to cancel that Phoenix.
Yeah, he doesn't realize it. Now he knows. And he's going right for the pylon.
Oh
my
god.
He's going to unpower it. And he's killing probes at the same time.
GG! Crank with a 2-0 victory. He counters his opponent's build. He goes for the DTs. They go unscouted. And the DT in the main base taking down Harvesters and going for the pylon that powers the Stargate. So he can't get any detection into the game. Patience has to type out. And Crank makes the 2-0.
That's a coin flip build, kind of, in a lot of ways. But it's a smart one because, you know, you say, okay, you're definitely not making Oracles. If you're making Oracles, you're making a bad choice. And if you do make Oracles, I already have a few Phoenixes that will deal with those, and then I'll have the Dark Shrine as a backup plan. I can get my expansion up. But if you don't see my Dark Shrine and you don't make Oracles, I just win. And that's it's a choice that you can make. It's pretty risky, but it paid off.
And talking about backup plans, the AZUBU coach needs a plan C right now because plan A didn't work, plan B failed, and now we are down to plan C. He needs a player that can not only take down Crank, but eliminate a lot more players from Axiom-Acer, and that is not going to be easy at all.
Oh, definitely not.
Crank is more one of those preparation players, you know, he's not the all-around monster that you just throw out to get like a massive amount of wins. He's a player that excels by preparing for certain matchups, he has a great work ethic, and he has shown that in the past. He prepared a lot for the match against Symbol, that was his main concern. He won against a strong opponent, and then he took out Patience now as well. And you can really see that him talking to not only Alicia, but also Innovation, they are also already discussing what's going on if he loses game number three.
Yeah, exactly. Crank, doing a great job so far. Crazy build in game number two, works out for him. And now he's probably feeling on top of the world because he has no idea who he's facing, but he's like, I've already done my job here. I've gotten two wins, and we still have Innovation on the bench.
Yep.
We still have Alicia on the bench, as well as some other Terrans like Ryung. So Axiom-Acer is going to be feeling like the game is almost already won. They've taken out the best player that AZUBU has to offer, and I feel like they might have to use Supernova here. Just even though you might want to consider using him last, they need to get that momentum. They cannot allow Crank to get a third win here.
The map, on the other hand, is Whirlwind, and the question now really being, do you throw out Supernova on Whirlwind, or do you try to just maybe even work with a Zerg player? Like, looking at the bench, one of the players that we could see later on is maybe Sleep.
Yeah.
He did really well, especially against Terrence just in the recent past, but he's a player that came out for the team already in the first season of the GSTL this year.
Yeah.
And did quite well. You have other players like Senna, of course, too, but like, I feel you want to mix it up a little bit and maybe a Zerg play, and if you throw it on the Zerg, you might as well use Whirlwind.
Yeah, Sleep would be the Zerg I think they want to use here. Sanai is just a little bit too inconsistent to put out in an 0-2 situation where you're down 2 points and you need a win badly. Sending out Sinai second instead of Patience could have been an alternate choice where you send him out. He's got a lot of time to repair. He's not going to get nervous. But
if you don't use Symbol and you want to have a Zerg play, I think Boom Boom would be the choice here.
Boom Boom is also a good choice, yeah. I don't know how good in shape Boom Boom is because we haven't seen him have a dominant game in a while. So that's a good point. I really had kind of pushed Azubu's Boom Boom out of my mind there for a little bit. But
it's definitely
it could be him.
Yeah, it's one of the players that they could run with. I kind of feel that they will save Supernova being the last player here. But be that as may, right now they're in trouble. And they need someone to give them a few wins. They thought that Symbol would be the one who would lead the game and the team match today and grant them at least a couple of victories, or at least the initial one. But that's not the case here. So I feel right now they are a little bit desperate and they have to come up with some kind of solution. They need a player that is really in tip-top shape today and can deliver a couple of victories.
Absolutely. And the question is, who is that? Who's the guy who's ready? Supernova has been well-rested on the bench. He's been sleeping, so...
You can see the coach in the back. He's actually like not looking too happy here. He's really thinking about what's going to be the next play.
Maybe one of three times in my lifetime I've seen him not smiling.
Yeah, he is very tensed up, and I mean for good reason. If you're down 0-2, you already lost Symbol, and you're only up against the starting player of your opponent's team, and Krank already defeated two. You didn't really think you would have to do that. You have a plan A, that's Symbol. You have a plan B, that's Patience, in case Symbol really loses, which you don't think will happen because he's such a strong player. But then you don't prepare anybody else for Krank.
Yeah.
Like, preparing two players for him already is, like, a lot. And then Krank is not really the guy that you think you will have to deal with in this situation. You know that Innovation is sitting on the bench.
Yeah.
You know that Ryung is there. So these are the players that you're really, really worried about. And you know that Krank is good, but you don't think that he's the guy who suddenly just takes two wins.
Krank is a great all-around player, but he's no Innovation, he's no Ryung, and he's a great starting player. He's an excellent starting player. But we've moved beyond that now. Now we're in... going into the third player that they need to put out here. And they're probably thinking maybe Symbol will bait out Innovation early. Maybe we think about that. But now they have to deal with Krank. And what's it going to be, AZUBU? Let's find out.
Yeah, here we go. So the next
center
player is going to be Center. Really not what I expected here.
Yeah, nor did I. But he has shown great Terran versus Protoss games in the past. Definitely somebody who could pull this off. But he needs more than one win. He really does.
Senda is interesting though. Senda is a player that they sent out the last time already and he was able to win his match, so that's something that we should definitely mention here. And you know, it was actually against a Protoss player on Whirlwind. It was against Hurricane, so I think that we're gonna see him for that very specific reason. That he prepared for Protoss in the match against FX Open back then, and Whirlwind was the map that he felt the strongest. It's still available in this team match, so the coach was probably in... He was in a bit of trouble. He was looking at the roster and was like, okay, we have Supernova, we have Senna here, we have Boom Boom, we have Sleep. Who do we send out? And against the Protoss player, I feel it's just it's just Senna is the one who prepared the most for Protoss lately. He has still the map that he prepared for. So I guess that's probably the reason why we see him now.
Yeah, and it definitely makes sense. I like this a lot, considering, you know, that history that he has of playing against Protoss on Whirlwind, the only match he's played this season, and he did win it. Clenching that victory for AZUBU back then, so we'll see if he can do it again. Because AZUBU is in dire straits right now, they need this win at the very least.
Yeah, they definitely need not only that win, they need a lot more. And of course, what already is going on right now is the Axiom-Acer bench talking about what's happening if Krank really loses the game against Senna. They have a lot of time to discuss this right now, talk about, okay, who comes out as the second player, who's going to be the third, who thinks he has the best chances against Senna, and what kind of maps are left, what map do you want to play. All these things have to be thought of, and the same is also true for the Axiom coach. He only has the last man standing if Senna goes down.
Yeah. Krank playing now his third match. He played a PvZ, a PvP. Now he's playing against a Terran in a PvT on a big four-player map. Protoss has been called strong in the late game, but Senna is a very aggressive player. He might not let Krank get there.
Yeah, he might be able to end this game early, but there's only one way to find out. We're jumping into the game here. Game 3 of the GSTL. Axiom-Acer is 2-0 versus Team AZUBU. And the third match between Krank and Senna will show if things change, if AZUBU can start their comeback. The GSTL, I love it.